If you live in Southern California, like I do, you have probably noticed something like this. If you live in Santa Ana, the college is at, for example, you wake up in late July, the temperatures are in the high 80s. You decide you're going to go to Newport Beach, and when you get to Newport Beach, you realize that the temperatures, and you notice that the temperatures are significantly cooler. The next day, you wake up, and your family wants to go visit the rest of the family who live in Riverside. And you go out to Riverside and you notice that the temperatures are significantly hotter than they were in Santa Ana. What is the difference between those places? Because latitudinally, there's no real difference. The difference is this: their relationship to a major body of water or their relationship to an inland area. There is something called the land water rule that has to do with maritime and continental influences. There are three sentences to this land water rule. I strongly suggest you know them. Here's what they are. The first one is this: land surfaces are rapidly and intensely heated under the sun's rays, and a land surface is like a continent, for example, whereas water bodies are only slowly and moderately heated. A water body would be like the Pacific Ocean. Number two, land surfaces cool off more rapidly and reach lower temperatures than water bodies. And number three, temperature contrasts are therefore generally great over land and moderate over water. In other words, there is a greater temperature range in inland areas than there is in coastal areas. How do you like this diagram? See the sun up there? On the left-hand side, you can see water, which is, let's say, the ocean. And on the right-hand side, land, let's say that's North America. Water bodies act as climatic modifiers. What that means is this: that means it doesn't get really hot next to major bodies of water, nor does it get really cold next to major bodies of water. We call this the maritime effect or the maritime influence, which is the moderating effect of water bodies on climate. There's five reasons. First, water bodies can have a high albedo, which means that the sun's energy when it comes in can be fairly easily reflected if the sun is coming in at a low angle. When the sun's energy is reflected, those short waves are not absorbed, they're bounced back up into the atmosphere, and as a result of that, the water doesn't absorb the heat energy. Number two, water, of course, evaporates, and evaporation is a cooling process. If you take some water and put it on your arm and swing your arm around, you will feel that area where the water is at on your arm is cooler than the rest of your arm that doesn't have water on it. It's because water is evaporating off of your arm. When it does that, it cools your arm. So evaporation also cools the ocean. Number three, the ocean is transparent, right? I mean, you look at it, you can see through it. If you can see through it, the sun can see through it. Because of that, there's deep transmission of the sun's rays, maybe 200 or 300 feet down in some cases. And as a result of that, what's happening is the sun's energy is able to heat water molecules the entire depth it's going down, which is a vast dispersal of energy. You're spreading the sun's energy out over a large area because of that transparency. Number four is this: you've probably been out of the water swimming with your friend, and you feel this burst of warm water coming at you from the direction of your friend. No, come on. That's not what that is. You can't heat the ocean like that. What it is this: warm and cold waters, because water's a fluid, mix. And that further disperses the sun's energy. And number five is this: water has a high specific heat. Water has a specific heat of one. Now, I'm going to lay my cards on the table. Specific heat is pegged to water, like a lot of things are pegged to water. You know, Celsius, the Celsius system works like this. At 100 degrees, water boils at sea level, and at 0 degrees, water freezes. Celsius is just pegged to water. We understand the way water works, so many things get pegged to water. So water has a specific heat of one, which means this: it takes 1 calorie of heat energy, to heat 1 gram of water 1 degree Celsius. Because of all those ones, we say that water has a specific heat of one. Okay, when the sun's energy comes in, 75% of the surface is covered with water, but the other 25% of the surface is covered with land. And as a result of that, the The sun's energy can come in and it can also strike the land. Now, because of that, we can also have something called the continental effect or the continental influence. And with the continental influence, what that means is this: inland areas, areas away from the coastline, tend to experience extremes in temperature. In other words, it gets very hot and it gets very cold depending on what time of the year it is. And there are also five reasons for that. Let's go through them. First of all, land has a low albedo, which means that it absorbs energy. It doesn't reflect it very well. And as a result of that, the energy that comes in and strikes the land from the sun actually gets utilized and it doesn't get reflected. As a result of that, the land can heat up because it's using the heat energy the sun is giving it. Number two, I mean, does dirt evaporate? Come on, dirt does not evaporate. Now, water can evaporate out of soil, which would be a cooling process, but water is water. So water is going to evaporate out of water. There may not be much water in soil if it dries out. So there's minimal evaporation, which means minimal cooling as a result of evaporation. Number three is this: the land is opaque. Can you see through the land? No, the sun can't see through it either. And because of that, there's no deep transmission of the sun's energy. It's all concentrated on the surface, which really heats things up. If you live in Southern California, you've gone through this too. You go to the beach, you're gonna meet your friend there. You arrive at the beach separately, and you forgot your flip-flops. You look over at the beach, and 100 yards away, there's your friend waving at you, "Here I am." And you start walking across the beach on a hot, sunny day. What happens to your feet? It's because all the energy is all concentrated on the surface. When you reach the towel screaming and yelling, after your feet cool off, if you just dig down 5 or 6 inches, you know it's significantly cooler down there because all the energy is concentrated because the land is opaque. Number four, of course, there's no mixing. You know, the dirt doesn't mix. Have you ever been sucked down into the earth and then thrown back up on the top? No, because the earth doesn't mix like that. It's not fluid. So there's all concentration. And then number five is this: land has a low specific heat. The specific heat is somewhere between 0.25, this is live, sometimes I make mistakes, 0.25 and 0.33. And because of that, let's say it's 0.25, the lowest of that, it only takes a quarter of a calorie to heat 1 gram of soil 1 degree Celsius. It doesn't take nearly as much energy to heat the same amount of soil up 1 full degree Celsius as it would water. So let's say that we had a full calorie coming in and we applied that to 1 gram of soil. So we have 1 calorie being applied to 1 gram of soil. How many degrees Celsius is it going to heat that up? Answer is 4. Very good.